knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
In the previous tutorial, we went over some general information regarding phylum Echinodermata. Now let's get into some more detail by examining echinoderm body systems. Echinoderms generally have an endoskeleton, coelom, water vascular system, digestive system, hemal system, nervous system, and reproductive system. Echinoderms, like the chordates, have an endoskeleton, but their endoskeleton is very different from ours. The echinoderm endoskeleton is directly beneath the epidermis and is comprised of small calcium-rich plates, known as ossicles, that are bound together by a unique form of connective tissue known as catch collagen, that the echinoderm can neurologically change from a liquid to a solid state, allowing the echinoderm to assume different postures without muscular effort. Spines and tubercles project from the ossicles to form the echinoderm's rough and spiny surface. The coelom of an echinoderm is a fluid-filled chamber that circulates fluids around the body cavity and into the papillae for gas exchange and waste excretion. It also contains amoebocytes that have a protective function against infection. Meanwhile, the echinoderm water vascular system comprises a second coelomic compartment made up of a series of canals and numerous tube feet that, when paired with the dermal ossicles of the endoskeleton and often the madreporite, create a hydraulic system that aids in locomotion and feeding. In some species, like the sea stars, it is the primary mode of locomotion, while others, like the brittle stars, have tube feet on their underside, but lack suction cups, so they are not used for locomotion. When sea stars walk, they do so upon their hydraulic tube feet. They do this by using muscular pressure to push coelomic fluid into the tube feet to stiffen them for walking, and the internal ampulla that connects to each foot acts as a fluid reservoir. Contraction of muscles in the ampulla forces water into the tubes, and valves prevent backflow. Echinoderm feeding strategies vary widely by class. For example, many sea stars are carnivorous and feed by everting their stomachs, beginning to digest their prey externally. Others, like many brittle stars, eat prey whole, while many urchins eat plant matter with self-sharpening teeth, and crinoids are mostly filter feeders. Regardless of the feeding strategy, food enters the digestive system through the mouth and moves through a short esophagus to a large stomach, often located in the central disc. From there, a short intestine leads to the intestinal ceca, and any undigested food passes out through the anus. In the sea cucumbers, the intestine is long and runs most of the length of the body, ending in a large anus, which is sometimes inhabited by other animals, while some sea stars lack intestines and anuses entirely. The echinoderm hemal or circulatory system is open and greatly reduced. It usually consists of a central ring and 5 radial vessels. There is no true heart, and the blood often lacks any respiratory pigment. Gas exchange and respiration instead occurs through the tube feet and papillae in starfish, genital bursae in brittle stars, peristominal gills in sea urchins, and cloacal trees in sea cucumbers. The echinoderm nervous system is radial and consists of a modified nerve net of interconnecting neurons and no central brain. Instead, nerves radiate from the nerve ring around the mouth into each arm or along the body wall. The nervous system attaches to sensory structures for chemoreception, photoreception, and touch. However, this varies by taxon. Sea stars generally have eye spots at the tips of their arms, but some brittle stars have very few sensory structures, if any. Though some sea stars can reproduce asexually, either through parthenogenesis or by cleaning their ventral disc, most echinoderms reproduce sexually. Sexes are separate, and the reproductive system generally consists of large gonads that are often held in each arm. Fertilization is external. Sperm and eggs are generally released into the water in mass spawnings. However, some cold water echinoderms do brood their eggs in special pouches, which they carry until the larvae hatch, metamorphosize, and become juveniles. Still others are viviparous and give birth to live young that burst out of their mother. And that wraps up the body systems. However, we're not quite done discussing the echinoderms. Since there are over 7,000 extant species in this phylum, let's continue by covering the biodiversity and diverse morphology of the echinoderms. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.